Python. It's known for data science, machine learning, and other things. But one thing it isn't known for is making games. And that's because it's not ideal for many reasons. But even so, it might be good for prototyping ideas, considering that it's higher level and fairly easy to use. Recently, I was inspired by Goodgis' coffee break roguelike, Squeaks and Squalls. I like the simplicity of it, but I wanted to make something with slightly more depth and content. And I thought it would be fun to make it in Python, especially since I've never made a game like this with Pygame. If some are wondering, Goodgis and I first learned Python back around 2018. When we both made a text adventure game to learn and also challenge each other. We also did an unofficial competition when he made Don't Touch My Presents some time ago. If you want, you can check these games out in the description. Now, Goodgis claims he made a better game and that I spent too much time on mine, but hey, whatever. So I started making some basic artwork, just a couple of tiles to get started. Afterwards, I added the basic Pygame settings. Then I tried drawing a window with a single wall texture. I got this working, and then the next goal was to draw a bunch of wall tiles, which I soon accomplished. Keep in mind, I'm no Terry Davis, and I was trying to get back into the game dev headspace. Once I was able to draw a bunch of tiles, my next major objective was to figure out level generation. I wanted this game to function more off of a grid-based system using arrays, so I made a level class that randomly puts room shapes in a level-sized grid, and then a function in the main file that generates the sprites or objects based on this 2D level array. I made the code slap more rooms down, and then I decided it was time to do some refactoring. My overall goal was to actually finish a functional game, even if the code itself isn't the best. But even then, why not tidy up and maybe get more Pythonic if I can? Moving on with level generation, rooms that intersected, no matter the shape or size, would now get added together internally. But of course there was a problem of dead ends and isolated spaces. This is when I started overcomplicating things, and where the pain began. I gave all the room types 4 openings, which would be connected with a pathfinding algorithm. This led me down a long and unpleasant rabbit hole. To make things easier, I blitted a debugging grid of the entire level to see the values being placed on the map. Anyway, I almost ended up writing my own A-star search algorithm. However, when I showed Goodgis my progress, he told me I had scope craved. Goodgis recommended that I look at how some of the early games, like Rogue, approached their level building. So I went back to the drawing board, figure out a much simpler way to connect the rooms. Embarrassingly, I have to admit, this was still a little tricky. I actually almost succeeded once, but then failed after confusing myself in a mess of convoluted code. I learned a few new Python tips along the way, and decided to restart the level thing. Sometimes, when I need to wrap my head around a concept, I find it helpful to draw it out visually. This helped me move forward. I applied my new Python knowledge and gave it another go, which proved successful. And now, we have fully connected rooms. With this milestone completed, I was ready for what I hoped would be an easier challenge, the player system, and everything else. So I made a player class and got some basic movement going. I decided to manipulate the level grid instead of relying on Pygame's built-in sprite functions. Perhaps this was a stupid choice, but you gotta make decisions if you wanna progress. I made ground tiles for more visual flair, and I tinkered with the player movement. Then I added collisions to prevent the player from leaving the level. After that, I wanted to give the player smoother looking movement, so I wrote that in, and here you go. After this, I wanted to refactor my code, specifically the level class, to be more object oriented. Again, I'm no programming Chad, but I needed to make it easy to generate more levels. So this process was a little painful, but straightforward. And this might make some angry, but I ran some of my code through an LLM to get feedback on how to improve. Maybe I could have asked the help of some elitist nerds on Stack Overflow, or maybe even on the Arch Linux forums, but for the sake of time and convenience, I went ahead with this AI machine learning approach. Don't hate me. Next in my project, I needed to add some breakable pots. I made some artwork and implemented these into the game. Then I had to rewrite the collision system, and I also ended up redoing the player movement too, which I like better. Before adding drops, I decided to make a basic goal or door that takes you to a newly generated level. I spent some time ensuring this transition worked flawlessly. Eventually, this will look more like Squeaks and Squalls, where you need a key to open the door, I could try other ideas too, but for now, this lets me play around with game progression when I'm ready. So, I'll have more updates in the next video, but I wanted to share this little journey with the world. One thing to remember is that your game will not make itself. Starting a game might be painful, but if you think you have a 1% chance of success, then push past the pain and see how far you get. And remember, start with small projects to gain more knowledge and experience. You'll be proud of yourself with every new breakthrough.